I'll let Josh set you up with everything, mics and stuff. Have you still got the other mic for the house? Cool.
Awesome. Is this the roster?
Yeah.
Sweet. Let me just, you know everyone's pronunciation, I assume? Yeah. Save me going down there just to make sure I'm not doing
it. Yeah, sure.
Sugarhead, Stone Cold Beretta.
Yeah.
Do you know people's shortenings?
Are
any of these? I might write down.
Yeah, cool. Yeah. Are you live now?
Yeah.
That was it, sorry. Josh, you don't have a pen, do you?
Miss Crunchbowl, Lethal Weapon.
Schrodinger.
Mind the Gap, Paper Cut, Escapade, Firefly Spirit, Lady Trample, Demolition.
Coup d'Italia.
Yeah. Is there a shortening for that?
Coup.
Easy, I'll do that. Yeah. Cooey? Sweet. Gale Force, Tough Vickies.
Jenny Dodgen,
okay. Kenzie, Tino Turner, Volcanic Ash, Bailey's Comet, Share Trouble. Share, for sure?
Yep.
Alex Zam, Vicious Veggie, Suffragette, Princess Slayer, Scandalous Public. Sweet, alright.
And then if you want to do any sponsor plugs,
yeah.
Chicks and Bowls, Green Monster, all the good
things. Are we doing them at any particular time? Is there any like camera line or anything?
No,
we just do it
yeah.
Sometime throughout.
Yep, yeah, anytime. And also, Schrodinger and Miss Behaven's mum is watching from Canada.
Okay, cool.
So if you want to do a shout out, that's all I got.
Okay. Cool. Alright. Are
you ready for first whistle?
Alright. No. I'm just doing it by myself?
Probably.
Yeah.
Okay. So you've got, this is the mic for the stream and this is the mic for the house.
Because okay. The mic itself, it's on a magnet.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But you're not getting any sound out of these, so you can either chuck it on.
Also, I'm not hearing myself through that anyway, so
they're just you can, like, if you want it just like that there, and you can...
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Pirate City Rollers versus Richter City Roller Derby. My name's Tui Lyon, I'll be on the mic for this evening. Do you know who we're doing first? First up, we've got our visitors. Let's hear it for Richter City Roller Derby. Skating for Richter City tonight, we've got Gale Force, Tough Vickies, Jenny Dodgem, Mackenzie, Tino Turner, Volcanic Ash, Bailey's Comet, Sure Trouble, Ella Kazam, Vicious Veggie, Suffragette, Princess Slayer, Scandalous, and Bubble O'Kill. Put your hands together, Richter City Roller Derby. Stepping up on the home turf tonight for the Pirate City Rollers, we've got Sugar Hit, Stone Cold Beretta, Miss Crunchbowl, Toot and Carnage, Lethal Weapon, Schrodinger, Mind the Yap, Paper Cut, Misbehavin', Firefly Spirit, Lady Trample, Gemolition, Hooey, is that Coup d'Italia?
Coup d'Italia, yeah. Coup d'Italia.
And Coup d'Italia. Put your hands together for both these teams tonight. Are you guys ready for some kick-ass roller derby action?
Close, or is that
it? Okay. Rorschach blowing the first whistle to get this show on the road. We've got Scandalous stepping up to the line for Richter City Roller Derby and Lady Trample for Pirate City. Richter City sporting some very shiny new uniforms tonight, looking awfully colourful, maybe with a dash of 80s in there, which never offends me. Both teams starting for an aggressive push off the jammer line. Lady Trample gets driven over the inside line. Scandalous working her way through the middle of the pack, and Trample is out for lead jammer for Pirate City Rollers. Hot on her heels, Scandalous not too far behind. Trample hits a tough three wall right at the back of the pack, calls that jam. Putting up 4 points for Pirate City Rollers and none on the board for Richter City. Nice strong start for the ladies in red and black. Number 451, Misbehavin' up there for Pirate City Rollers with the star. Princess Slayer for Richter City. Richter opting for a four back wall, looking nice and solid on the back. One in the box for, oh no, we've got a braced wall up front for Pirate City. Slayer working up that outside line. She sneaks past them all and grabs that lead jammer status from the outside. Misbehavin' punching her way through the pack, not too far behind her. Slayer hitting that Pirate City wall at the back and calling it. She's looking for three and she gets three from the jam ref. That's three on the board. First points out there for Richter City Roller Derby.
Have we got a scoreboard? Where is it down there? Yeah, is that cool? Sweet, thank you.
Sorry.
No, that's fine.
We've got Sugarhead on the line for Pirate City going up against Scandalous again, second time with the star for Richter City, and she does a good job with it right out the front for lead jammer status. Sugarhead still working her way through. She finds a line on the outside. Scandalous working up through the center of the pack, taking a few hits from that Pirate City defense. She makes it out and ends it for 4 points for Richter City. So we've got our first lead change of the game. 4 points on the board for Pirate City, 7 up for Richter City now. Penalty box hasn't been too busy so far. We've got one sitting for each team, so we've got 3 versus 3 in the defense for both teams. Coop up on the line for Pirate City. Mackenzie on the line for Richter City. Mackenzie goes straight up the middle, runs into that Pirate City braced defense. Both jammers out. The Pirate City jammer able to grab that lead jammer status, but it's neck and neck coming out. Coop says, nah, I had enough of that. Hits it and quits it, calls it off. No points for either team on that jam. Lots of love going out on the jammer line there. I'm loving seeing all these hugs and fist pumps. This is going to be an incredibly competitive game, but it's awfully nice to see those great attitudes as well. Princess Slayer up on the line for Richter City, Lady Trample for Pirate City. Richter City's a little slow on the defense. A little short on the defense, sorry, because they've got two sitting in the box. Gives Trample an easy lead jammer status. She gets that really quickly before the pivot line. Bashes her way through that inside line, says 4 points, and she keeps going. 5 points, sorry. She gets the jammer lap point on that one. Slayer now out of the pack, not too far behind her, but Trample's going for a few more before she calls the jam off. Aggressively taking that inside line. Looks like Scandalous was able to steal 4 on that pass though, so a good grab there for them on those, on that last jam. Some sneaky points on the board. Scandalous and Misbehaving back up on the jammer line for both teams. 3-on-3 on the track. We've got two sitting in the box. Misbehaving finding a way around on the inside line around that Richter City defense. Some fancy footwork to nab. It looks like she's got that lead jammer status. Scandalous now out of the pack. Scandalous coming in for a scoring pass. Misbehaving calling it off, but I think not quite quickly enough. Again, Richter City stealing those points. 2 jams in a row, taking points when they're not lead. 2 on the board for Scandalous in that jam. That's taking our total for 13 points for Richter City and 15 for Pirate City. Sugar hit up on the line for Pirate City. We've got Mackenzie with the star for Richter City. Seeing lots of similarly formed defense tonight. Both teams opting for nice strong brace walls. Again, both jammers out the pack. It looks like Richter City nabbing the lead jammer status, but it's neck and neck. And she says no, calling it off. No points by either team. Such a competitive game so far. Both jammers getting out of their pack at a super similar time. We're swapping lead nearly every jam, swapping lead jammer status nearly every jam. Coop up on the line for Pirate City Rollers, Princess Slayer for Richter City. Slayer hits the outside aggressively, pushing the back of that Pirate City wall, but she's met with some great defense from Cuddy and her teammates shutting down those lines. Meantime, Pirate City jammer Coop out for lead jammer status. She's approaching the pack, hitting up that inside line, knocked over the line by the Richter City defense. She calls the jam. After nabbing 2 points, 2 for Pirate City on that one, 0 for Richter City. So it takes us to 17 points for Pirate City Rollers, 13 for the visitors. Up on the line we've got Lady Trample, number 54, wearing the star for Pirate City, Scandalous for Richter City. Got 5-on-5 on the track, the penalty box is currently empty. Trample finds an outside lane wide open, nabs that lead jammer status. Scandalous still working through that Pirate City defense, pushing up the middle while Trample approaches for a scoring pass. There's a blocker in her way, but it's not really a bother. She just takes her the hell down and takes those 5 points, picking up the jammer left point on that pass. Scandalous still having trouble working her way through the pack. She's looking to her coach for advice, but told to keep going because Scandalous is still on initial pass and now, unfortunately, sent to the box for a cut track. So we've got a power jam for Lady Trample and the Pirate City Rollers. One heading to the box for Pirate City. Trample again heading for another aggressive pass, smashing her way through the center of that Richter City wall. It's coming at her just as aggressively from the Richter City blockers, though unfortunately a little in the wrong direction from Bubble O'Kill, picking up a direction of gameplay penalty. Trample calls it off after another 5 points. That's a big jam for Lady Trample. Let's hear it for Pirate City Rollers! That's really the first opening in the scoreline that we've seen tonight, taking Pirate City to 37 points, Richter City on 13. Pirate City sending Misbehavin' number 451 out onto the line. Scandalous still in the bin for Richter City. Little bit of offensive help from the Pirate City players there, helping Misbehavin' to sneak out and grab lead jammer status. Scandalous back on the track from the box. Makes quick work of that Pirate City defense straight up the center. Misbehavin' now approaching on a scoring pass. Also having a similar time. She's knocked over the line, calls the jam. Looks like she was able to get that jam called off before she re-entered the track, picking up 4 points on that pass. So a nice little run now from Pirate City, taking them up to 41, Richter City 13. Not surprisingly, the coaches from Richter City coming in to question that one. That Misbehavin' did re-enter the track as she was calling the jam, and I'd imagine, just speculating, that he'll be questioning whether she did fully enter the track before the fourth whistle or not. I'm a mind reader. So great use of an official review there from the Richter City bench. While we've got a minute, guys, I want to do a big shout out to some of our fantastic sponsors that helped put on this weekend's event. We've got the Derby Depot, Chicks in Balls. They were putting on a great meetup today at the skate park, seeing some excellent stuff out there from all kinds of skaters. Green Monster Roller Sports. Big thanks to our wonderful venue, the ASB Stadium. Joe Mack Photography also. NZCT Community Trust, you have our thanks also. So we've got a pretty exciting weekend of roller derby, full contact putting on an amazing weekend. We've had excellent discussions today about league structures and the future of New Zealand roller derby. We've had park skating, and tomorrow and the next day we've got some two excellent fun-filled days of some straight up top quality coaching from some excellent coaches from all over the world. So super exciting weekend of roller derby happening in Auckland, New Zealand. I know we've got a lot of people tuning in from overseas, which is super exciting. There was definitely a serious lack of crowd participation on that Mexican wave. There was about four very committed people to that Mexican wave, and that was about it. They're awfully loud up the end there as well. All right, concluding that official review, Rorschach now talking to the captains and coaches, having a discussion and just delivering his reply. So if Richter City were successful in that official review, we will see Mackenzie head back to the box. If not, we'll see Sugar stay out there with the star for Pirate City. Mackenzie up on the line for Richter City Roller Derby.
Whose mum was watching from Canada? She wanted me to do a shout out, but I can't remember whose mum it was. Or two people's mums.
Does Ruth know?
Yeah, Ruth knows.
It doesn't matter.
All right, no one's sitting in the box for Pirate City Rollers, so it looks like that official review was not successful for Richter City. We're going to start the jam with two on the track for Richter City, all four for Pirate City. Richter City running forward at the last minute, looking to get that no pack call and give their jammer a little bit of space. Unfortunately, not successful. Pirate City straight up. Doesn't really matter to Mackenzie, though. She's quick out the front of the pack, grabbing that lead jammer status. Again, jammers neck on neck. Mackenzie just calling it off, being safe. Richter City being very conservative with those call-offs, making sure they're not giving away any points in those close jammer-on-jammer contests. Coop up on the line, number 73 for the Pirate City Rollers. Princess Slayer, number 666 for Richter City. One sitting in the box for Pirate City, so we've got 4-on-3. Richter City with a pack advantage. Coop working up the outside. Slayer hits the in. She's pushing 1-on-1 and grabs that lead jammer status right out the front. Very aggressive derby we're seeing here. Super aggressive jammers really, really bashing their way through those defensive formations. Cuddy putting a bit of heat on Slayer, but she's able to get through and call it for 4. Quick hit it and quit it for the ladies from Richter City Roller Derby. 4 points on the board. Big shout out to Shro and Miss B's mum watching all the way from Canada. Super exciting to have everyone tuning in from overseas. And so excited to bring you this game tonight. It's fun to be part of such an excellent weekend of derby. Lady Trample on the line for Pirate City up against Scandalous for Richter City. They're all cramped up on the inside. Trample looking for a little bit of jammer defense. Scandalous not too fazed by it. Oh, big collision at the back of the pack from number 162 from Richter City, taking down Trample. Scandalous in the meantime worked her way through the front, picking up lead jammer status. Trample not too far behind her. Quite a fast moving pack here. We've got Richter looking like they're really trying to run up that pack speed and open that defense up for Scandalous. They're able to do so and she grabs 2 points. Nothing for Pirate City on that jam. So that's taking Pirate City score still on 41, taking Richter City up to 19 points. Misbehaved on the line for Pirate City, McKenzie for Richter City. We've got 4-on-4 in the defense. Bubble kill smashing through for McKenzie, doing a bit of offense, opening up that Pirate City D at the front. McKenzie fighting up front, taking down by number 64, Jemolition. Some great two-wall defense, now three-wall defense, holding back McKenzie. Unfortunately, Cuddy off to the bin for Pirate City. McKenzie called on a cut track. She's also going to sit, so we've got 2 in the box for Pirate City. Misbehaving, fighting her way up the front. She's taken over the inside line by the Richter City blocker, but able to make her way out for a lead jammer. We had a full lap of the track before that lead jammer was established. She is working for that lead jammer status. Jamalition and Yap heading in for some offensive help, helping her out. But she's got tough work of it with that Richter City D there. Bubble O'Kill at the front wearing the pivot, really slowing her down, taking her over the inside line and drawing her right back to the back of the pack. All players back out on the track now. We've got both jammers in it. McKenzie making her way out. A nice little pirouette on the outside through. Not lead jammer. That's already been established. And the jams ended 5 points on the board for Pirate City. And they were an awfully hard-fought 5 points. Ladies and gentlemen, let's put it up for Misbehaving. She's doing work out there. Sugar hit up on the line for Pirate City. Princess Slayer for Richter City. We've got 4-on-4 in the pack. Both jammers punching up the center. Sugar working up front against a Richter City braced wall. Slayer able to open up that Pirate City defense and find a line on the out. She's through for lead jammer status. Not far behind her though. Sugar's out of the pack, not lead jammer. Slayer looks for a line on the outside. She looks like she gets it. She's calling for 5. And the ref says 4. So it takes Richter City up to a 23 points, 46 on the board for Pirate City. We got 15 minutes remaining in this first half. This is some hard-fought roller derby, guys. It looks seriously physical out there. Like I said before, some super aggressive jamming. Lots of big hits happening in the pack.
There's no one. I can't see. Oh no, she's. She pointing to Pirate City? Is the official pointing to Pirate City? I can't see behind the skaters. I'm trying to figure out whose time it is. I can't see.
Looks like that was a team timeout for Pirate City, taking a moment to get themselves together. They've still got a reasonably commanding lead over the game, opened up from that power jam earlier, which was definitely the highest scoring jam of the game so far. Resuming play now, we've got Coop up on the line for Pirate City and Scandalous for Richter City. Penalty box not seeing too much action tonight. Everyone's being very well behaved. Scandalous hitting up the middle. Coop looking for an inside line, getting quickly shut down by the Richter City defense. Scandalous still working that Pirate City D up the middle. Coop finds that inside line on turn three, out for a lead jammer. And again, I've been saying it all night, Scandalous right behind her. Both jammers quickly out of the pack. Coop opts for the outside line, is met by Tino Turner and shut down. No points on the board for her. Again, Richter stealing another point when they're not lead. One on the board in that jam. They're doing an awfully good job of stealing those sneaky points. Lady Trample on the line now, number 54 against Mackenzie, 118 for Richter City. A little bit of dancing going on, shuffling about. Nice offensive attack on the inside from the Richter City blocker then. Not enough to help her out. Lady Trample out for lead jammer status for Pirate City. Richter City jammer unfortunately getting called on a cut track. I think from memory that's the second for Mackenzie tonight. Looks like that jam ended. I think Trample called it off, but I didn't see. Probably not realizing that it's a power jam. Unfortunately, it was quite late out of the pack that she was called. It's looking like 2 points up on the board for Richter City. Oh, sorry, for Pirate City. So Mackenzie sitting with the star for Richter City. Trample back out on the line. One jam's not enough. She's hungry for more. Three blockers out there for Pirate City, opting for some quick offense. Trample dropping a shoulder into that Richter City defense, opening it up herself. She finds a space on the inside line, out for lead jammer. Again, such aggressive jammer styling, hitting straight through the center of that Richter City defense, super aggressively, opens it up in just a hot second. Snaps 5 points for Pirate City. Again, hitting the middle. This time, Richter defense getting the better of her, taking her down. Mackenzie now back on the track from the penalty box. Pirate City doing some great lateral defense, moving from in and out, in and out. Taken over the line there by Yap. Trample also getting drawn back by Bubble O'Kill and Princess Slayer. Making quick work of the solo blocker at the back of the pack. Takes out one of her own buddies, but I guess that's probably okay. And she's through for another 5 points for Pirate City. So that takes Pirate City up to 58 points, Richter City on 24. I spoke too soon about that penalty box, guys. We've got 2-on-2 in the defense for both teams. Scandalous able to compromise on that first, getting out for lead jammer. Again, not too far behind her. Sugar's right on her heels. Scandalous takes a big hit from one of the Pirate City blockers, nabs those ghost points. She's got two in the box. She only needs to pass one person, so she picks up three and calls it off. Again, we've got some amazing fitness shown from our jammers here tonight. Multiple jammers going back to back, which is super impressive. Again, two on two still. We had such a short jam, no one was freed from the box, so two on two for both teams. Coop out there for Pirate City. Scandalous did such a good job of it last time, and she's eating it up all over again. Out the front for lead jammer for Richter City. The box emptying out now. We've got five on five back on the track. Scandalous gets past a couple of hips and calls it. The jam ref says three. 3 points again on the board. So we've got a nice little streak there for Richter City. Taking them up to 30 points. Pirate City sitting on 58. Trample on the line for Pirate City. Mackenzie, number 118 for Richter City. Pirate City opting for a front wall. Mackenzie gets a little bit of a run-up. Trample taken over the line by the Richter City blockers at the back of the pack. Again, aggressively throwing those shoulders into that space. Both jammers working super hard here, getting taken down. Trample finding a hole through the center of the Richter wall, and she's out for lead jammer status. She had to work for that one, though. She's looking a little tired. Looks like we've got a star pass happening. Mackenzie's quit it, passed it off to the pivot for Richter City, which is Ella Kazam, number three. She's drawn over the outside line by two Pirate City blockers right up the front, and they're taking her all the way back. Big hit on Trample as she comes in. It almost looked like that was assisted from her own blocker then. She's also drawn back. Got some big hits happening in the pack right now. Trample getting drawn over the outside line by the Richter City blockers. And unfortunately, looks like Ella Kazam thought she'd been called for a penalty, but the ref waved her back on. Trample ends it before she hits the pack. Hard to know if she actually made her initial pass then or not, as she was sent off and then waved back on, but definitely a safe call and a smart call on the side of Pirate City, ending that before she could potentially score. So got 67 on the board for Pirate City, 30 for Richter City. Again, just holding that lead that was opened up earlier by Lady Trample on that big power jam. Misbehaving, looking up the outside line for Pirate City. Slayer, though, makes quick work of the inside. She's out to grab lead jammer status. Coming in hot to the pack, we've got a big, wide Pirate City defensive wall at the back there, which she makes pretty quick work of. Both jammers on the ground there. Looks like we've both got points on the board. I'm seeing three for Richter City and one for Pirate City. So Pirate City beating Richter at their own game there and stealing a little point. Scandalous on the line for Richter City. We got Sugar hit up for Pirate City. That box looking suitably empty now, back with 5-on-5 on the track. Bubble O'Kill again doing some work for her jammer up front against that Pirate City defense. Some quick offensive hits, and then she drops back for D. Unfortunately, Sugar getting sent off for a forearm penalty. Scandalous works through that D, out for lead jammer status for Richter City, and it's a power jam for Scandalous. Richter City quick in to give some offense, but not good enough as number 18 for Pirate City takes her over the inside line. Again, defending the front of that pack like a boss. Scandalous again drawn over the inside line, and she's having her third attempt at this scoring pass now. Pirate City putting up a great defense, getting hit left, right and center, but she's got five in the sky for Scandalous and Richter City roller derby. Pirate City unfortunately bleeding a couple of blockers during that pass. Lovely offense up the inside line from Bubble O'Keel, making a much easier pass for Scandalous that time. In the meantime, Sugar is back out of the box and through on her initial pass. Scandalous coming through for her third scoring pass. Nabs a couple but gets slammed out the outside by Crunch. Still picking up 3 points on that pass though, so that's a great jam for Rector City. That's what they really need to close down this gap. So we've got Pirate City sitting on 68, Rector City sitting on 46. I think that was probably one of the biggest jams for Rector City. Let's hear it for Scandalous! Princess Slayer taken over the inside line by Cuddy. We've got Coop working up front against a strong two-wall from Rector City. They're doing some great defense up there, really making it hard for her. Again, such aggressive derby, such big hits happening out there. Coop out three on her initial pass, but Scandalous is scoring. She gets taken over the inside line by Yap and calls it for 2 points for Rector City. Another big shout out to our sponsor, Derby Depot. I saw them out in the foyer, so make sure you pick up some merch this weekend. Looks like they had lots of great gear out there. Lady Trample on the line for Pirate City. Vicious Veggie stepping up on the line for Rector City. I think potentially her first time on with the star tonight. Again, Bubble O'Keel helping her out, playing some great O this game. Lady Trample quickly out for lead jammer status. Veggie just unfortunately not able to save that cut track. She saved the first one and then just quickly got drawn that second one. She's quickly making her box way to the box. So Lady Trample now on a power jam for Pirate City. This is not really what Richter wants at this moment when they've just picked up a bit of momentum. She's taken over the line by Tino, but Tino going out of bounds, so Lady Trample able to re-enter legally. Calling for her blockers to come in. Crunch is a good person to send in. She's taken people down. Oh, makes her way past on the inside, but unfortunately getting called for a forearm as she helped herself around that Rector City blocker with her forearm. Veggie now returning from the box. So we've got a power jam out in Rector City's favor. And she's doing nice work with it, making a quick pass there. That was her initial, so she's not scoring yet, but making her way around, getting a little caught up the front. Again, Crunch at the front of the pack. We've seen it a few times. She just says, no, jammer, no. Getting run right back by the Pirate City defense. And that was some excellent power jam kill there from Pirate City. Trample back now out on the track, taking over the inside line. Man, this is a tough game for the jammers. There is lots of big physical hits. Trample now out on another scoring pass, putting four on the board for Pirate City. Veggie still making her way through on her first scoring pass, but she's done it. She's out for four also. Looks like that jam timed out there. I reckon Pirate City were able to nab a few extras on the end there. Four by the looks of it, all 4 points on that last pass for Lady Trample. So a pretty points heavy jam for both teams. Pirate City coming out on top of that, 87-53 for Rector City. Just 2 more minutes left in our first half, ladies and gentlemen. We've got Scandalous stepping up onto the line for Rector City, Misbehaving for Pirate City. Just got a little bit of an official timeout at the moment, I say, by the looks of it. Great opportunity to thank some of our other sponsors. Big shout out to Green Monster Roller Sports. The man himself, Quadzilla, is here in the building, teaching us some excellent roller derby skills this weekend. Another big shout out to Chicks in Bowls. Again, so awesome to see them teaching some excellent stuff to amazing women on quads all ages today. It was really cool. All right, we're back on the road heading into what could be our final jam of the half. Richter City setting up a three-wall defense at the back with one player hovering up front for a Scandalous. Pirate City with four at the front. That offensive help coming from number three is just what Scandalous needs, and she's out for lead jammer status. Oh, unfortunately, a cut track penalty going the way of the Pirate City jammer, and that's a power jam for Scandalous. She did an awfully good things with the last one she had. Let's see what she can do. She puts five in the sky for Richter City Roller Derby. Again, aggressive help from the Richter City players, really getting in there and messing things up for her. Jem putting a bit of pressure on at the front of the pack, but it's not enough. She's through for another five. That's 10 points in this, Jem. Great to see offensive help nearly every single pass from the Richter City players. Scandalous making her way around the outside. Nice little pirouette to pick up that last point on Jem. Misbehaving now back out of the box, pushing up that Richter City wall. She's making them work. Scandalous again now on a third scoring pass at the back, working against the Pirate City defense. And misbehaving through, she's picking up, that was just her, initial pass. No points on that one for her. Scandalous taken over the line, but not before she grabs 2 points for Richter City. So big jam for Richter City there. Taking them up to 70 against Pirate City's 87. So we've got a 17-point game. What a way to close that gap, Richter City. Five on five on the track. Sugar up there for Pirate City. McKenzie for Richter City. And the refs say no. Let's take a break, guys. So that's halftime now. Pirate City finishing on 87. Richter City on 70. I guess we did that one.
Thank you.
70.
It is. No,
I don't want to fall for it.
Do you want something to actually, you know what? Oh, I'm not sorry. I'm saving you.
Discretion is the better half of that.
Sorry guys, promise I won't unplug anything.
Computer to it.
beautiful. Under a minute left in our halftime. Both teams getting ready. Pirate City getting fired up with a big cheer right before this second half. ...1-1-8 for Richter City. Big shout out and thanks to ASB Stadium again. It's a fantastic venue for the bout tonight and also for the boot camp over the weekend. So happy to be here. Thanks for their support. We've got officials fleeing the building here. Such a hard-fought first half. Pirate City finishing on 87. Richter City really closing the gap in that second half, the end of that second half, with 70 points. So just a 17-point lead for Pirate City heading into the second half now. No doubt they'll be looking to get some of that momentum they showed in the first half of the last half. And, of course, Richter City to continue on where they were. Big shout out to Joe Mac Photography. Thanks for your support, Joe. Another sponsor of our excellent weekend of roller derby here. And also big thanks to NZCT, New Zealand's Community Trust. The skaters look ready to go, but it looks, and Rorschach says he is too. So that's great. Lady Trample opting for a bit of a run up from 20 foot back. Again, 5-on-5 on the track. And we're on Lady Trample. Oh, getting a lovely little toe up that inside line. Stumbling as she gets out of the pack, but she's able to grab that lead jammer status. Mackenzie right on her butt. Also out, but not lead jammer. Richter City looking to get to the front to save their points. Trample has to end it because Mackenzie was right on her heels there. No points for either team on that jam. Pirate City sitting number 451, Miss Behaven out on the line. Scandalous, the captain, said it's stepping up for Richter City. Scandalous working up the center and then the inside. Miss Behaven finding a gap right up the center. fights past the last line of defense for Richter City, out for lead jammer status for Pirate City. That's two in a row for them. Miss Behaven got a little bit more space between her and Scandalous than in the last jam. She goes right around the outside for 4 points. Let's hear it for Miss Behaven. 4 points on the board for Pirate City. Hits it and quits it. That takes Pirate City up to 91. Richter City yet to score in the second half, still on 70. Princess Slayer, number 666, up on the line for Richter City. She's a very successful jammer for Richter in the first half, so looking to put some points on the board this jam. Sugar, number 08 for Pirate City, stepping up. Slayer again making work with Bubble O'Kill up the front of the pack, getting a lot of help out there, and that gets her the lead jammer status. Big hit taking Sugar over the line, but unfortunately number 5 for Richter City also goes out, so she's back on the track. Meanwhile, Slayer's slamming through the center of that pack, grabbing some points. Looks like she's able to grab all 4 for Richter City. That's the first points up on the board in this half. 74 for Richter City, 91 for Pirate City. We've got Coop, number 73, with a star up there for Pirate City Rollers. Number 118, Mackenzie, for the ladies in purple and orange. 5-on-5 on the track again. We've got a bit of an interesting two-two walls up the front from Richter City. That's a different strategy. I haven't seen that before. They came together nicely, though, to shut the defense on Coop at the back of the pack. Richter City jammer Mackenzie making work up the front. She's out for a lead jammer status. She's got half a lap on Coop there. And she's coming in. She sees that apex and she takes it. Big apex jump there, putting 4 points on the board. That's a stylish way to put 4 on the board for Richter City there. Again, continuing that momentum there. 78 for Richter City. Richter sending Slayer back out on the line. She grabbed some points in her last jam, first on the board in this half for Richter. Pirate City sending out Lady Trample, number 54. Slayer working up the outside. Trample working up the inside. And bit of a foot race, and Slayer is out for lead jammer again. Just beating Trample out the front of the pack. Pirate City setting up their defense at the front. And Slayer slamming in and pulling off the jam. Only nabbing 1 point, but one is very, very important in a game this close. Takes Richter City up to 79. Pirate City sitting on 91. Misbehaving on the line, number 451 for Pirate City. The captain, Scandalous, number 78, back on the line for Richter City. Again, 5-on-5 out there. Misbehaving working against that defense at the back, that brace triangle wall slowing her down, but she finds a spot driven over the inside line. Scandalous now pulled back to the back of the pack by the Pirate City defense, but she finds a little gap on the outside. Picking up Lee Jammer status. She just got past the last hips there. And unfortunately getting sent off for a forearm penalty and on a hit on Paper Cut right at the front there. So we've got both jammers going to the box as well. So that means Scandalous is back on the track, quick, smart, back out to score some points for Richter City. Pirate City jammer won't be far behind her. Misbehaving now out of the box too and re-entering the track. Scandalous out of the pack for 5 points, picking up that jammer lap point on that one. Misbehaving working against a tough brace wall at the back. She gets taken down at the back of the pack and then reabsorbed by the Richter City defense. Scandalous working through at the back against the Pirate City defense. So we've got some tough work from both jammers here. Really, those brace walls putting up a tough fight for both jammers. Misbehaving able to get out of the pack. Unfortunately, that one was just her initial pass, so she's not scoring yet. Obviously, if we've got both jammers heading to the box, we'll have no lead jammer anymore. So we're going to go the full 2 minutes on this one, both jammers. Scandalous getting strung right out. Nice big daisy chain out back by Pirate City. Meantime, Misbehavin putting four on the board for the ladies in black and red. Scandalous still working up through the center. And that was a hard jam for those jammers. Both teams putting up great defensive work there, really making those jammers work for every one of those points. Some on the board for both jammers in that jam. So 95 for Pirate City. We're now at 83 for Richter City. Still awfully close game. One sitting in the box for Pirate City. So we've got a 4-3 advantage in favor of Richter City. Number 118, Mackenzie on the line for Richter City. Number 8, Sugar, stepping up on the line for Pirate City. Mackenzie looking for a line on the outside, but again, we've seen it so many times tonight. Crunch just takes her the hell out of bounds. Some great stringing back from Pirate City tonight. Really good bridging work seen from them. Sugar making quick work. Nice agile footwork around the outside, picking up 5 for Pirate City on that pass. Mackenzie now making her way out the pack. Still fighting against the Pirate City defense, but she's able to make it through for her initial pass. Oh, unfortunately, Sugar getting sent off for a cut track there. Again, that's lead jammer getting sent to the box, so we're going to go another 2 minutes with this jam. Good work from Mackenzie, able to shrug off a hit from Crunch on that inside line and make it through for her first scoring point of pass, picking up 5 points for Richter City. Getting taken over the outside line by the Pirate City defense. Big hits getting thrown in the pack. Such a physical game. Drawn over the inside line by the Pirate City defense. And she says, I've had enough. Bubble O'Kill, it's your turn. So we've got a star pass through to Bubble O'Kill. She's getting taken over the inside, then the outside, drawn back by Crunch right at the back of the pack from Pirate City. Oh, we've got an illegal procedure call on Sugar. Unfortunately, she's just come out of the box and she's going straight back in. We've now got a power jam for Bubble O'Kill. Pirate City doing a great defensive work, drawing the jammer over the inside line. Unfortunately, Pirate City bleeding blockers to the box. And a good work, picking up 5 points for Richter City on that power jam by Bubble O'Kill. So Richter City starting this next jam with a huge advantage. We've got 3 players, including the jammer, sitting in the box for Pirate City. And they're sending out Princess Slayer number 666 to try and put some points up on the board. So that last jam took Pirate City up to 100 points, Richter City to 93 with 20 minutes remaining in the second half. Quick start to that inside line. Princess Slayer makes it look easy, grabs that lead jammer status, no trouble. Just 2 on the track for Pirate City, certainly making it a slightly easier job. She's still met with some strong defense at the front there. Unfortunately, Cardi off to the bin for Pirate City. Princess Slayer putting 5 in the sky for Richter City. Sugar now out of the box, completed her initial pass. Princess Slayer through for an untouched pass on that one, which is certainly made easier if half of Pirate City are sitting in the bin. Sugar looking for a spot up the inside line, but she's taken over the line by the Richter City blockers. Princess Slayer gets in for some points and calls off the jam. Looks like she picked up 4. That's a big jam for Princess Slayer and Richter City. Ladies and gentlemen, can you see that scoreboard? 102 versus 106. Richter City take the lead. What a great full game of roller derby. We're seeing some of New Zealand's best players here fight it out. Some excellent teamwork. And that's certainly showing on the scoreboard. Such a tight game. Lady Trample on the line for Pirate City. She ate up that inside line with a quick pirouette. scandalous, working around the outside. She's met by a Pirate City blocker, but unfortunately not taken out of bounds. Again, Trample heading up that in. She puts four on the board and ends the jam. So four very needed points for Pirate City in that one. That's taken it to a tied game, ladies and gentlemen. 106 versus 106. Coop up on the line, number 73 for Pirate City. 118, Mackenzie up there for Richter City. Richter City really just sprinting up just before that jam whistle is blown, trying to cause a no pack and get Mackenzie a little bit of space to breathe. Unfortunately, she's drawn over the line, but she's still out. Oh, we've got a double jammer penalty. Mackenzie sent on a cut track. Looks like the Pirate City jammer Coop sent on a legal procedure. I didn't catch what that was, unfortunately. Mackenzie sat first, so she is out first. Followed quickly by Coop, both jammers back on the track. Again, we're going to go another 2 minutes with both jammers going to the box. Mackenzie working against that Pirate City D up the front. She's able to make it through the center. That's her initial pass, not scoring on that one just yet. Coop still working her way through. Tino Turner giving her a tough time in the center of the track there. Richter sitting and doing a great job with that brace defense, mate, really making Coop work for it at the front there. Unfortunately, doing a little bit of it in the wrong direction, so getting a direction of gameplay penalties. Vicky's is being sent off for that. Unfortunately, for Richter City, Mackenzie heading to the box as well. So we've got a power jam now for Coop and Pirate City Rollers. Tino Turner again giving her a tough time, trying to draw her over the inside, but she isn't able to. Coop through for 5 points for Pirate City Rollers. A little bit of a turn of the tides in the penalties now. We've got Richter City bleeding blockers left, right and center. Coop working against the two wall at the front of the pack. Unfortunately, Tino heading for Richter City. There's some fierce play going on out there. Mackenzie back on the track now. And that's our jam timed out. What a jam, ladies and gentlemen. 3 points on the board for Pirate City. I can't quite see how many are up there for Richter.
Is he giving five?
Two? 2 points on the board for Richter City on that last pass. So that takes us to 119 for Pirate City, 109 for Richter City. We've got a 10-point lead to the ladies of the home ground advantage. Trample finding a spot on that outside line now. Princess Slayer going up the middle and getting held up by the defense of Crunch. Still working, Slayer working up. Trample, though, through on her pass, picking up that jammer lap point as well. So that's five on the board for Pirate City. Princess Slayer now out on her initial pass. Trample laying some big hits up there to pick up those extra points. Another four on the board for Pirate City. Shakes her head and says she's fine, back on her feet. Quick check from the medics and she's feeling okay, so taking herself off the track. Some amazing athleticism on display here today from both teams. Misbehaving number 451 on the line for Pirate City, 78. Scandalous out there for Richter City. 128 points on the board for Pirate City. They're pulling away a little bit now with another 10-point jam and that last jam from Lady Trample. 109 on the board for Richter City. 15 minutes remaining in this second half. All right, we're back on track now. 5-on-5 on the track after little penalty spirals from both teams in the previous few jams. So full strength for both teams. Misbehaving, working up that middle and then to the outside. Scandalous getting taken down at the back by some of her own players, unfortunately. And Misbehaving out the front for Lee Jenner for Pirate City. This is what they need to close that gap now and take that win home. Scandalous not far behind her through on her initial pass. Misbehaving looking for a spot on the inside. She gets a couple, calls it. She gets three. Three on the board for Pirate City. Nothing for Richter City. We got Lady Trample versus Princess Slayer on the line. Opting for a jazzy old-fashioned pivot start, line start for this jam. It's always nice to get a little bit retro. And we've got Richter City calling a team timeout. So it looks like they're wanting to just take it down a notch, calm it, and maybe find a little bit of that momentum they had at the end of the second half, or the first half, sorry. Great opportunity to give a huge shout out to some of our sponsors for this weekend. Thank you so much to Derby Depot. They've got a booth in the foyer. Make sure you check them out. Chicks in Bowls, helping people learn how to ramp skate. Green Monster Roller Sports, making all kinds of fantastic roller derby things. NZCT Community Trust, ASB Stadium, and Jomac Photography. Richter City done with their little team chat. Got a little support from their fans in the bleachers. And we're heading back out with 131 on the board for Pirate City, 109 for Richter City. Both teams starting up on that pivot line. Trample opting for a bit of a run out. Slayers starting on the jam line. One sitting in the box for Richter City, so we've got a 4-3 pack advantage in favour of Pirate City. That inside line was left open. Trample jumped over it anyway. Snatches that lead jammer status. Quick star pass from Princess Slayer to the pivot. Trample shuts that down with a big hit. Vicky's able to stay in bounds, maintain her footing and pop that star on. Trample going for a quick grab of points on the inside. Big hit from the Richter City defense, taken right over that line. Quick smart, not able to pick up any points on that pass. Great defensive play by Richter City on that pass. Number 8, Sugar on the line for Pirate City. 118 McKenzie for Richter City. We've got 13 minutes remaining in this half. Again, going for a pivot line start, giving both jammers a nice little run-up. Sugar hits that Richter City defense right in the middle. McKenzie getting a little more space working up front. She's going one-on-one with Yap, and she's through to steal lead jammer status for Richter City Roller Derby. Sugar still having trouble with the defense at the back of the pack. McKenzie now on her scoring pass, nearly knocked over the line. Unfortunately, the Pirate City players calling for a cut, but the ref didn't see it, didn't agree with it, so no call on that one. McKenzie now in on another scoring pass. And she probably picks up a couple and ends it. The ref is saying she's picked up maybe 3 points. Yeah, 3 points on that pass. Nothing for Pirate City. So couple points on the board there for Richter City, exactly what they're looking for. That was a strong jam from McKenzie. 117 for Richter City, 136 for Pirate City. Coop on the line for Pirate City, Scandalas for Richter. Coop playing a little bit of defensive jammer work. Unfortunately, the ref said it wasn't legal defensive play and she's sent to the box. So we've got a power jam for Scandalas, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it for Richter City Roller Derby. Scandalas making quick work of that Pirate City defense up the front there. Lead jammer status issued to her. She's coming around now for a scoring pass. Having a tough time against that Pirate City defense. We've got a strong two wall up the front there. Getting drawn right back by the Pirate City D. Coop now out of the box and she's through on her initial pass. Scandalas ends it after picking up 5 points on the, five very much needed points on the board for Richter City. So it takes Richter City up to 122, Pirate City on 136. Again, another pivot line start up there. It's hard to tell who's really making the decision to draw the play up there, but it's been working well for both jammers. Slayer getting a run up from the jam line. Trample starting a little bit further behind. Going in Slayer's favor on that one, and she's through for lead jammer. Nice little side surf on the inside from Lady Trample to get her out of the pack. Slayer, quick, hit it and quit it from Slayer. She's calling for a three, and the ref says one. So still 1 point, better than nothing. Can't complain about that. Points on the board, definitely what Richter City needs at this point in time. Only 9 minutes remaining in this second half. Still a super close game. We're trading leads and points every single jam. So super exciting roller derby here happening in the ASB Stadium. Sugar drawn over the outside line. Getting toyed with by Vicious Veggie at the back of the pack. Buying her plenty of time for McKenzie to get up and nab that lead jammer status for Richter City. McKenzie now sneaking around for a scoring pass. Pirate City swirling defense, but she does a tidy little pirouette to pick up her points. Sneaking in on that inside line, grabbing 4 points for Richter City Roller Derby. Pirate City calling a team timeout. Only 8 minutes remaining in this second half, so a good time to regroup with your team and chat about what your plan is. Pirate City sending Coop out with the star for the next jam. Princess Slayer for Richter City. Big shout out to our sponsors again. Thank you so much to Derby Depot, Chicks in Balls, Green Monster Roller Sports, NZCT Community Trust, the wonderful ASB Stadium we're sitting in, and Joe Mac Photography. Richter City saying we can do this in their team chant. They've got the confidence. Opting to take a few more minutes. Richter City now calling a team timeout. So we're trading timeouts at the moment. Both teams obviously needing some time to regroup, to chat, maybe catch their breath. It's a pretty fierce game out there. Such aggressive play, such big hits from both the jammers and the blockers. Who in the building is coming to do some excellent roller derby training tomorrow as part of the full contact boot camp? Quite a few people by the sounds of it. Let's hear it for full contact for putting on this excellent weekend of roller derby. All right, that's the timeout done with from Richter City there. As I said before, number 73, Coop, stepping up to the line for Pirate City. Number 666, Princess Slayer on the line for Richter. Nobody in the penalty box, so we've got 5-on-5. Coop working up against the Richter City defense on the inside. Princess Slayer drawn over the line by Jemolition there. Called for a forearm penalty, so we've got a power jam now for the Pirate City Rollers. Coop coming in now for a scoring pass, hitting just three Richter City blockers. We've got, four Richter City blockers. It's Princess Slayer sitting in the box. She's through. Quick work of 5 points for Pirate City. Setting up in a staggered 2-2 wall for Richter City there. Coming together as Coop hits. Princess Slayer now out of the box. She's got the panties stashed. But she's still fighting through that wall. So who knows what's going on. Coop still making her way through on a scoring pass now. So Slayer just doing a stash so she could hopefully sneak through. Pirate City saw her coming, so she's got it back on now, coming in for a scoring pass. Quick weave around that broken Pirate City defense, and she's out for putting some points on the board for Richter City Roller Derby. Both refs are calling for 5 points on that pass. So we've got 146 on the board for Pirate City, 128 for Richter City. Still Pirate City pulling away with a slight lead. Only 6 minutes and 56 seconds remaining in this second half though. So a power jam or a good strong 15 pointer, that definitely could do it for Richter City. So out on the line with the star, we've got Lady Trample. She jumps over Suffragette to grab that lead jammer status. Scandalous out, not lead jammer, but not far behind us. Eats up that apex jump. Let's hear it for Lady Trample. 4 on the board for Pirate City Rollers. That was a pretty sexy 4 points. One sitting in the box for Richter City at the moment, so we've got a 4-3 pack advantage for Pirate City. Misbehaving out on the line on the start with the star for red and black. Mackenzie out there for Richter City. Misbehaving fighting up the outside. Mackenzie also stuck in the center of the pack. Both jammers doing some good work. Big hits, but it's Misbehaving that fights it out. This is the momentum that Pirate City need to take hold of that lead and shut this game down. Jem doing a nice little offensive clear on the outside for Misbehaving, making quick work of those 4 points for Pirate City. Nice and tidy offense on the outside there. She goes to the box for it, but you know, maybe it's worth it. Again, sending out number 54, Lady Trample for Pirate City. Princess Slayer on the line for Richter City. Both these jammers have had an excellent game, putting up plenty of points for both of their teams. Trample getting driven over the inside line by the Richter City defense. Slayer pushing out front against Pirate City, and she pushes them, unfortunately, with her forearm, picking up a forearm penalty on that one. No lead jammer status issued at this point. Lady Trample coming in now for a scoring pass. She's knocked over the inside by Bickies. Little pirouette on the in and she's through, putting some points on the board for Pirate City. This power jam, definitely not what Richter City needs at this point in the game. Five on the board there for Lady Trample. Aggressively hitting into that lead. Unfortunately, the jam ref says she also hit her down with her forearm, so she's going to go sit now for a power jam. Princess Slayer coming in from the box, but unfortunately being sent off for a cut track and now an illegal procedure. That's going to be a full 1 minute in the box. Double penalty for Princess Slayer in the Richter City Roller Derby. There's illegal procedures going on all over the place. Hui now sitting for an illegal procedure. Princess Slayer obviously only sitting for one penalty, not two. She's now back on the track. Meanwhile, Lady Trample has passed the star. Crunch, who's been delivering some awfully big hits now, is going to be delivering them as a jammer. Both jammers on the track, both scoring. 3 minutes left in this game. That's some exciting roller derby. Crunch being taken over the outside line, getting a little taste of her own medicine there from the Richter City defense. Again, smashed over that outside line. Princess Slayer through on another scoring pass. We've got three on the board for Pirate City in that last one. Also three for Richter City. So three on three for that last pass. That was an exciting jam. We got takes Pirate City up to 167, Richter City to 133. So Pirate City really opening up a nice little lead towards the end of the game here. Only 2 minutes and 45 seconds remaining in this second half. Pirate City opting for a team timeout just to cool their jets, take a moment and discuss their final few jams. So probably only a couple of jams left in the game tonight, but still only a 29-point lead at this stage, so a 31-point lead. I'm not very good at math. I promise I'm good at other things. I haven't got any beats. Quadzilla's calling for some tunes, but I am no beatboxer, so I'm going to say a big fat soz, mate. Not going to happen. Does that sound good? Unrecognizable chant coming from the bleachers. I don't know. I can't quite make out what they're saying, so unfortunate about that. That's ending that Pirate City timeout. They're taking the track. They're ready to go. Officials still in a nice little huddle, obviously having some important discussions there. What an excellent game of roller derby, guys. Such hard fought points for this game. 167 for Pirate City, 136 for Richter City. This is definitely some of the best derby that New Zealand has to offer. Quite a few Team New Zealand, some skaters out there on both teams, lots of national skaters. Super awesome to see them going head to head tonight in some top-notch derby. Number 78, Scandalas, on the line for Richter City. Pirate City sending out number 73, Coop. Scandalas driving up the center of that Pirate City defense. Coop working her way up front. Looks like she's getting some space around the Richter City defense. Through for lead jammer for Pirate City. Oh no, we've got a forearm penalty for Scandalas. Not what Richter City needs at this point in the game. With just a few jams to close that gap, you need your jammer in a scoring position. Coop safely working her way up the center of the track there. She's just carefully making her way against that tough defense. Again, Tino Turner working hard up the front. Tough Vicky's also shutting her down, but she's through for 5 points for Pirate City. Coop coming in for another scoring pass. Richter City putting up a tough defensive wall, drawing her over that inside line. Putting three on the board, not to be sniffed at. Great jam for Coop there. 8 points on the board in that jam, extending Pirate City's lead to 175. Richter City still sitting on 136. Scandalous did make her way out of the box at the end of that jam, so we've got both jammers up on the line for this, what could be one of our final jams. Lady Trample for Pirate City, Mackenzie for Richter City. Trample takes a nice big run up and gets driven over that outside line. Run back by Suffragette, and she gets the cut track. Lovely draw of a penalty there, sending Lady Trample to the box. Mackenzie working up that inside line. A much needed lead jammer status for the Richter City Roller Derby. Richter City now heading in for some Mackenzie making a quick pass up the inside with some nice offensive help from her blockers, making that so much easier. Coming through for another scoring pass now. Pirate City setting up a nice defensive brace wall, slowing her down a lot more on this pass. Pablo Kill heading to the box for Richter City. Mackenzie working her way through the center of the pack, and she's through for another five in the sky for Richter City Roller Derby. Lady Trample now out of the box and making a quick pass on the outside line there. Definitely a bit of assistance for her part from her Pirate City blockers there as well. Oh, Lady Trample going for a big apex jump, but not landing that one, getting that inside line shut down by the Richter City defense. She's already had a few of those pretty apex jumps tonight, and they just say no more. Again, driving her over that inside line. Mackenzie having a tough time up back against the Pirate City defense. She's had enough, and she says it's time for Bubble O'Kill to take the star pass for Richter City now. Bubble O'Kill fighting up against that Pirate City defense. Trample coming in hot again. Big hit on the back of the Richter City D, taking down one of the blockers at the back, but through for another 5 points for Pirate City. Bubble O'Kill pirouetting around the outside of the defense, putting four on the board for Richter City. So that's a big jam there. Looks like it's taking us to the end of the game. Our score's not official yet, but it looks like we've got Pirate City on 184, Richter City 150. We'll wait for the official word from the referees. And that's it. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for your victors, the Pirate City Rollers! Huge thanks and congratulations to Richter City, also putting up a fantastic effort tonight. That was a top-notch game of roller derby. Thanks everyone watching at home and everyone here tonight. Thanks so much to all our officials skating and non-skating tonight as well, doing an excellent effort keeping everyone safe and everyone tidy on the track tonight. Lots of hugs left, right and center in both teams at the moment. Both teams have a lot to be proud of. That was an excellent game of derby, putting up some excellent moves from both teams. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's see the victory lap. Put your hands together for the Pirate City Rollers. Deserve them tonight after that game.
150. Ladies and gents, put your hands together for the women from Wellington. It's Richter City Roller Derby. I'm going to sign off. My name's Tui Lyon, and I'll see most of you guys tomorrow on the track.